Hello students, I'm Dr. Rohan Khandelwal. I'm a breast cancer surgeon and a surgery faculty. And in this video, I'll tell you about the TNM staging for abdominal cancers. And I'm just going to simplify it for you so that you can remember it for your exam. Now, you know that TNM staging, invariably, there's at least one question from TNM staging in all exams. So in this video, I'm talking about the abdominal cancers. First, let's talk about esophageal cancer. So I want to tell you a simple trend, and if you can remember that trend, you don't need to mug up all the TNM stagings for abdominal cancers. So if you look at esophageal cancer, you know that T stage here will talk about the depth of invasion, right? And if you look at TIS, that is high grade dysplasia or in situ cancer, T1, what I want you to notice is T1 is going into the lamina propria or the submucosa. So it is not going into the muscle. T1 is above the muscle layer, right? So T1 in most of the abdominal cancers is above muscle layer. I'll tell you the exception. T2 is when it invades the muscle. T2 is when it is gone into the muscle. T3 is usually perimuscular tissue, right? T3 invariably will be perimuscular tissue. I'll tell you the exception. So T3 is perimuscular tissue. T4 is when the adjacent structures are involved, right? So T4 is invariably the adjacent structures in any cancer, that is T4. So this is regarding esophageal cancer. If you look at the nodal staging, the nodes for esophageal cancer, N0 is no regional lymph nodes. N1 is 1 to 2 positive lymph nodes, right? And N2 is 3 to 6 positive lymph nodes. N3 is 7 or more. This would be same for gastric cancer as well, but for others, the exception I'll let you know. M0, you know, is no distant metastasis. M1 is the presence of distant metastasis, which in esophageal cancer goes to the liver. Also, let me tell you about the 8th AJCC update for esophageal cancers. You know, this is the Sieverts classification for gastroesophageal junction tumors, GE junction tumors. You have the Sieverts classification. This has also been asked in the exam. Type 1 Sieverts are 5 cm proximal to the gastroesophageal junction to 1 cm proximal to the gastroesophageal junction. That is type 1. Type 2 are 1 cm proximal to 2 cm distal to the gastroesophageal junction, that is type 2. And type 3 is 2 cm distal to 5 cm distal, that is type 3. Right? And the update which I want you to remember, that type 1 and type 2 are treated as esophageal cancers. Type 1 and type 2 are esophageal, whereas type 3 is now treated as gastric cancer. This is the 8th AJCC update, which you need to remember for the exam. It is extremely important. So this is what I've told you. Cancers of the gastroesophageal junction that have their epicenters within 2 cm proximal of the gastric cardia are staged as esophageal cancers. The others which have epicenters more than 2 cm distal are now staged as gastric cancers. Now, if you look at the TNM staging for gastric cancer, you will see that there are a lot of similarities with esophageal cancer. So T0 is no tumor. TIS is in situ. Okay, TIS is again in situ. T1, remember T1 was above the muscle layer. Here also T1 is above the muscle layer. So same as esophagus. It is the same as esophagus. T2 is when the muscle is involved. This is also same. T3 is subserosal connective tissue or the perimuscular tissue. This is also the same. T4 is adjacent structures. This is also the same. So it is the same as esophageal cancer. Similarly, if you look at the nodal staging, 1 to 2 lymph nodes, 3 to 6 lymph nodes, 7 or more lymph nodes is N1, N2, N3. This is also the same as esophageal cancer. So if you can remember, esophageal cancer, gastric cancer, TNM staging is exactly the same. You don't need to mug this up separately. So they both are same, esophageal and gastric. I've also told you the update. Moving on to colorectal cancer. Colorectal cancer, the TNM staging, the T stage, if you look at it, if you look at the T stage, T0 is no tumor. TIS is in situ cancer. It is the same. T1 is submucosa. So this is also, we are still going same as esophagus, right? Everything is going same as esophagus. T2 is when it invades the muscle layer, this is also same. T3 is perimuscular tissue, this is also same. And T4 is adjacent structures, this is also same. This is also same. So you can see that the T staging is the same for esophageal, gastric, and colorectal cancers. The nodal staging is slightly different here. So N1 here is 1 to 3 lymph nodes, as opposed to gastric and esophageal, where it was 1 to 2 lymph nodes, here it is 1 to 3 lymph nodes. And N2 is 4 or more lymph nodes, right? So this is the difference. This is different from esophageal and gastric. So you should just remember that the nodal staging for colorectal is different as compared to esophageal and gastric. Metastasis remains the same, distant mets. Further subdivision is into M1A, M1B and M1C, which I'll just tell you. One more colorectal cancer update is that T4 is divided into T4A, that is tumor directly invades the serosal surface through inflammation. And T4A should not be used in non-peritonalized portions. We need to remove minimum 12 lymph nodes for proper staging of colorectal cancers. And lymph node status is the most important prognostic factor. M1 is divided into M1A, B, and C. This is also different from the other cancers which I've spoken about. M1 is metastasis confined to one or more organ site without peritoneal mets or non-regional lymph nodes. This is an update which you should remember. Non-regional lymph nodes also makes it M1A disease. M1B is to two or more sites or organs without peritoneal mets, and M1C is mets to the peritoneal surface along with other organs. So this was regarding colorectal cancers. Now the exception, gallbladder cancer. This has been asked in the exam and I want you to understand the difference here. So T0 is no tumor, this is the same. TIS is in situ, this is also same. But here T1 is invasion of lamina propria, but T1B is muscular layer involvement. So up till now, whatever cancers we've studied, that is esophageal, gastric and colorectal, muscular invasion was occurring in T2. But here in gallbladder cancer, it is occurring in T1B, right? Because you need to remember there is no submucosa in gallbladder cancer. Muscular layer involvement is T1B, not T2. T2 is perimuscular tissue. In others, T3 was perimuscular tissue, but here T2 is perimuscular tissue. T3 is when it perforates the serosa or directly invades the liver or another structure like stomach, duodenum or omentum. And T4 is when the main portal vein, hepatic artery or other organs are, two or more other organs are involved. So gallbladder is different, this you need to remember. And the T staging has been asked in the exam. N0 is no regional lymph nodes, N1 is lymph nodes along cystic duct, CBD portal vein. So there is no number assigned to it as in the other cancers which I've just spoken about. So gallbladder is different, you should remember about it. Pancreatic cancer has also been asked in the exam. It was asked in the UPSC exam last year. And what you need to remember, T1. Now, up till now, for all the tumors, the four tumors which I have told you, it is the depth of invasion. The T stage is according to depth of invasion. But here they've taken into account the size. Right? So T1 is less than equal to 2 centimeters. T2 is 2 to 4 centimeters. T3 is more than 4 centimeters and T4 is adjacent structures like we have discussed till now. So this is also different, this you need to remember. Pancreatic cancer is also different, you should remember the values. If you know, this is similar to the values which we've seen in oral cancer and in thyroid cancer as well. Less than 2, 2 to 4, more than 4 centimeters. N0 is no regional lymph nodes, N1 is 1 to 3. So this is similar to colorectal cancer. N1 there was also 1 to 3 and N2 is 4 or more lymph nodes, same as colorectal cancers. M1 is the presence of distant metastasis, right? So this was in nutshell the TNM staging for abdominal cancers. So let me just summarize the points which I have told you. Esophageal, esophageal and stomach are the same. So if you can just remember one, the other one you don't need to memorize. For colorectal cancers, T stage is same as esophagus and stomach. The end stage is different. This you need to remember. For gallbladder cancer, T stage is different. You need to remember. This has been asked in the exam. Right? And finally, for pancreatic cancer, the T stage is dependent on the size and not the depth of invasion. So T stage is dependent on the size. You need to remember it. It is the same as gastric. It is the same as oral and thyroid cancers. And the end stage for in pancreatic is same as colorectal. Right? So this is just a summary of what I have told you. These are simple points which can help you in remembering the TNM staging. If you like the video, please press the like button. Do drop in a comment and I will reply back to that if you have any queries. You can subscribe to my YouTube channel and also follow me on Instagram, where I keep on posting questions as stories there and you can answer them as well. In my next video, I'll be discussing questions pertaining to TNM staging, and I'll be talking about TNM staging for other cancers as well. Thank you.